Sometime between 1820 and 1832, William Henry Jackson, professor of the University of Georgia, and the son of James Jackson, the congressman, senator, and governor from Georgia, took a good long look at a tree on his property. That tree gave him a lot of good memories. He cherished that tree, and he knew that the tree, which had stood before he was born, would continue to stand long after he died. So he took his deed to the tree and he wrote up a document which read as follows. I, W.H. Jackson, of the county of Clark, in consideration of the great affection which I bear said tree, and my great desire to see it protected, do convey unto the said oak tree and tie up possession of itself and all land within 8 feet of it on all sides. So with that document, just with the stroke of a pen, the tree owned itself, a magnificent piece of nature, tamed and regulated by humanity, now given the freedom simply to exist on its own terms. How often do you see that happen? But, in response, the people of Athens took one of its acorns and planted a new one. Because that's what the tree would have wanted. Is all this a little bit silly? Yes, it is. Are the people of Athens kind of wasting their time? Yes, they are. But do I blame them? Yes, I do. But, like many things that are kind of silly, in a way, it's also kind of beautiful. If a tree can be autonomous and independent and make its own decisions in spite of all the structures and laws that we've built that say the trees just don't do that, why can't we?